coming at you with another video review. This time I'm doing something a little bit different, as you can see. I'm going to be doing a quick review of Transformers Revenge of the Fallen for the Xbox 360. Now, when you log in, this is what you have here. I'm going to quickly go over here and I'm going to sign into my account. And there you see me, Optobotomus, signing in. And there we go, doing all that stuff. Hopefully this will turn out fairly well. I've never done a video review of a game. Where's my thing? Here we go. So we're going to go in here. Hopefully I have the volume up good enough so that you can hear exactly what's going on the game itself. So here we have just my television screen. Don't know if I'm actually supposed to have this show up on here, but whatever. I'm going to do whatever I want to, because I can. Here we have the Activision logo spinning around, really kind of cool looking. I actually really like the way this next logo looks. This is the Hasbro logo. And the way they did this is really neat looking. Very cinematography-esque. But there you have it. Really good. Paramount, Viacom, I don't know if I'm supposed to show that either. DreamWorks, who knows if I'm supposed to show that. This is rated T for teens, and there's all that stuff. And apparently that helicopter that Grindor is, it's called the Super Stallion. Now here's the opening screen for it, and in a second we're going to see, there goes Soundwave. Hovering around. So this is the main screen for the movie, for the game itself. One thing that I don't particularly like, that you see the right, it's really bright right there, so it kind of takes away from things. So we're going to go ahead and hit start. And I have to select my hard drive. And there are games that were found on progress, because I've played this a little bit already. Here we go, don't turn things off. Now, as you see on this this side over here, which is very hard to see, I'm going to try and, I don't know if you'll be able to really see all that. Resume game, new game, leaderboards, multiplayer, replay, audio credits, cheat codes, and achievements. That's all the stuff that you can achieve, I guess, in the game. I'm going to go to resume game. And I need to zoom back a little bit to get the entire thing in the camera. There we go. As you see, the Autobot side, I have 27% done and then 5% done on the Decepticon, so not much. But I'm going to go to the Autobots real quick. And it loads everything up. While in helicopter mode, you can hover in place and aim by holding the left trigger. It shows you different things. Here's the Autobot's main area, main base of operations. And through here, you can select different sections to go through. Some are locked. As you can see, the East Coast Industrial Area is locked. But some of these other ones are unlocked. I'm just going to go to the tutorial. Okay, so here's the tutorial. And it's got different things that you can see. On this side right here, it shows you the zone summary. The missions unlocked, missions completed, campaign points earned, and all that stuff. I have 4 out of 5. So we're going to go in here. And when you select it, it gives you more options right on this side. You know, or more, you know, your personal best time, your personal best score, how many campaign points you've earned. The thing that's kind of cool is you can select, here's Bumblebee, and that's the only one you can select for the tutorial. So, and he gives you his stats on the right-hand side there. So we're going to go ahead and select him. It's going to load up. Now, the one thing that is kind of actually... Oh, that's kind of... Needs to focus. Things are moving around too much. The comms will soon renew their attacks. We must all stand ready. Ironhide, it is time Bumblebee returned. Make sure he is prepared for combat. Guarding the boy has been far too easy. We must be certain that he remembers how to fight. So there you go, Optimus Prime giving Ironhide instructions. Now here we have a little cutscene.
Bumblebee, it's good to have you back.
As you can hear, you have Ironhide that throughout this entire thing gives you instructions on things to do. So what you need to do is follow what he wants you to do. Now, it also tells you, so you can move around. You, during the tutorial, you can only do what they want you to do. Right here it says, use the left toggle thing to walk around, use the camera, which I was doing. So he wants you to do this. move around. And then the on-screen radar, which is right down here, tells you where to go. There's a little yellow thing, and I'm running towards this guy, and that's it. Literally, that's all you do. Now, you have different camera angles. That's what this is telling you. You can zoom in closer, a little bit further away, and even further away now. So here we're running to that again. And I'm just still running. The radar is going to show it, and then this tells you where to jump, and you push A for jump. And again, Ironhide gives you more instructions. You run forward. I've done this a couple times. Now, you can jump to the wall. Now, if you jump, it doesn't do anything. You have to jump and hit the A button or the B button, and it'll hold on to the wall. So you're going to climb up. There's the little checkpoint. All set. Let's try something more interesting. Check your radar. Now, more beacons have shown up, and then you have to kind of run around and get to them yourselves. So you just kind of run and jump. There's one.
Too easy, but try to stay with me. I promised Prime not to skip the signal stuff.
There we go. We're going to run around here. Here's the other checkpoint. And there's another one right in front of me. So we're going to run. And at this point, I can't transform because he hasn't taught me how to do that yet.
Good.
There we go. Now,
let's do. Let's move on. Head to the next location on your radar.
Now, if you hit pause, normally during the actual game, right in here, this section right here, it'll give you a list of bonus things that you can do to complete, such as perform 5 aerial takedowns, where you're in the air and you kill somebody, or perform 10 power jumps, things of that nature. Different things to give you goals to do throughout the game. So here we go. Now this is telling me about the melee attack, which is the X button, and if you hold it, you can just randomly go around. Now, these are droids, so they want you to practice. Now, you can do a charge one. I'm going to do a charge one over here. If you hold it down, you can see he charges up and zoink, and he kills people. Beautiful. Now, it says a chain attack. Hit X 3 times in a row, and as you can see, this guy now has a life bar, so we're going to just kind of keep hitting him until he dies. There we go. And he constantly keeps talking about how it's on your radar, so we're going to just run, jump, can't do anything else yet. Now we're going to learn about the unique special abilities. Bumblebee, oops, all of them have special abilities that if you hit the Y button, they do it. This, for Bumblebee, he actually stuns his opponent. So you hit the Y button, sends out an EM pulse, and then you can take the person down because they can't move. So now he's dead. Checkpoint. Now we're going to learn about the weapon mode, where you actually get to shoot things. Holding down the left trigger and then the right trigger will shoot. Just like so. Left trigger will zoom in on the target. And there you go. And it says that enemies release Energon when they are eliminated. This Energon can be used to upgrade in the war room between missions. And there we go again. Now you can change your primary weapon by hitting the R1 button. As you can see, it switches from left to right. Again, target. And he shoots missiles. You can get a charged attack. There we go. And this just tells you about how to lock into the target. There we go.
Of course it didn't look hard, but good job. Let's see what's next. Check your radar.
Again, checking our radar, we now see that there's a place that we have to run to, all the way over here. And this is going to prompt us to use our transformation gimmick. The transformation, the moving around is a lot nicer on this game. So now he talks about speed and all that stuff. And he teaches you about vehicle mode. Now, when you're just like this, holding down the right trigger will have you transform. But you have to hold the right trigger down, and then you steer around. holding down the right trigger, driving around, collecting those little guys. There we go. One more checkpoint. I missed that. And there we go. And that's him driving around. Now it's going to show you advanced maneuvers. When you hold down the A button, or when you hit the A button, it bursts into speed zone, boost engaged, whatever. And I want you to do a power brake. So here we go, hold that down.
You can slow down or slide to catch your enemies off guard.
Hitting that will allow you to fire. Hitting the X button will allow you to shoot your gun in the move. There we go. So there we go. Now we're going to do some jumping. Now holding down the transformation button, and then the A allows you to power jump. Doing the same thing, holding down the transformation button. Hold down X, then release the transformation button.
Now if you really want to get the letter,
and you do a move. And then a ground pound, which is the B button. So again, transformation, hold down the B button. Very simple. And it says I did well.
Nest won't win without us.
So he's rambling on about talking about Nest. Go. I'm just hurrying up here. And
you know what this puts me in the mood for? A good fight.
There we go. And what flight? Oh, I'm sorry. There we go. I'm sorry. I talked about the plaything and then we're not even at the plaything yet. No. And it says, congratulations, you unlocked all Autobots in the West Nodes, blah, blah, blah.
You are ready. Now, keep going. Incredible. Make me proud. Now, let's see. Who's next? Ah, yes, the fly boy. Breakaway.
There we go, now we get to fly with Breakaway. And it just says you unlocked all G1 episodes, or unlocked the G1 episode Fire on the Mountain by collecting the skill thing. So, again, performing different feats will allow you to unlock certain things. And now we're going to do the flying thing with Breakaway. There we go.
Your first objective.
It says it has a unique set of weaponaries things now, secondary weapons and things of that nature. Now with Breakaway, he actually has a sniper rifle. Zoom in. There we go.
You're not ready for this. You're not ready for this. Well done, Breakaway.
There you go. As and here comes all the Energon.
I cannot fly. I'm sure I'd be good at it, but no wounds. However, I can run a review. Now let's go over your flight systems. Your on-screen radar will show your first target. Head for it.
And jet mode. And I missed it. So I'm going to try and do a loop-a-de-loop. I'm not very good at flying, apparently, either. Alright, here we go. We're going to spin around. I can't find this stupid thing, so... Again, I'm completely lost. Now, he actually walks around a whole lot more slowly than Bumblebee does. But the controls are quite interesting.
I could do a lot with a pair of wings. It's breakaway.
And the final one.
Very good. But I wonder how you are with more advanced concepts. The radar is waiting.
See, he walks around a whole lot slower than Bumblebee does. Now he wants to do the flight boost, which, again, very much just like Bumblebee, it's the A button.
Good. Now let's mix it up. Keep the enemy guessing with moves like this.
Says a stunt maneuver. Press the left direction and then press the B button.
Excellent.
There we go.
Now the most important part. Weapons.
Shoots missiles. Go.
I guess you really love those wings. Nice.
So it's a very interesting game. And it says that I've completed the tutorial, so that's fantastic. Now I'm going to land.
Well done.
And that's it.
Now, go bust some deceptor chops.
Overall, the game is actually pretty entertaining. It's better than the first game, in my opinion. There are more objects and obstacles and things that you have to do in this. Here's my little health thing, and then you can add whatever you want to it. You can unlock things, as I said. For example, collecting the skill shots allows you to activate this and... watch the episode Fire in the Sky by the Transformers. I'm not going to play too much, but things of that nature. Unlock... here's War of the Dinobots. Another G1 episode. So it's actually pretty entertaining that you can watch these and unlock these things in the game. They give you different things to do. And for example, I'm going to load in this one, load in this game. Clash in the Canals. Now here you can pick to be Breakaway. You can be Ironhide. Optimus Prime. Ratchet. Or Bumblebee. Now there are supposed to be ones that more playable characters being released, but I'm gonna pick Breakaway because I don't think I've actually ever been him in a game situation yet. So here it's loading up.
Nest has located additional Decepticons in the canals. Hunt them down and eliminate them.
Prime sounds mean, so we're gonna hit C to A to continue. And there's Breakaway.
Enemy targets verified. Locate and engage Autobot.
There's human people talking.
Autobot, move out! Enemy spotted in Sector 1.
There we go. Sector 1. Now, like I said, on the side here, right there, there are different objectives. Kill 10 enemies with the advanced melee attack. When kill 3... command HR, or all three commands must survive. So they give you different objectives to complete. The more that you complete, the better things are for you. And there you see there's one. So I'm going to blast that. I think I'm going to blast that.
Decepticons inbound to your location.
Oh, blew up. I'm flying around blowing stuff up. I'm getting my butt kicked. Oh. And they keep telling you stupid stuff that you already know. You know, so that's pretty much it. And of course, unfortunately, this is as far as you can run. And of course, you don't want to die.
Autobot, you cannot sustain those damage levels.
Decepticon damage.
There we go, blew that guy up.
Losing health, Autobot.
So I'm in sniper mode, I'm looking around for Deceptic Chops. He's flying around, so I'm gonna zoom back around this way. Do I see any here? Well, maybe not.
Enemy inflicting heavy damage. Stay safe. Decepticons. They're taking hits.
But so overall, oh, there we go. So overall, I do highly recommend this game. It's very entertaining. I wouldn't pick it up just right away. Probably wait until it's a little bit cheaper. But it is a vast improvement over the first game. Hopefully you could see some of the things that I was talking about. I'm going to quit the mission. And that's about it, guys. I mean, it's a very entertaining game. I do recommend picking it up. I'm not that good at it, but it's a very good game, and it's entertaining, it's fun, it's better than the first, so if you can see it when it gets a little bit cheaper, not necessarily right away since it's brand new, but I would recommend picking this game up. So until next time, guys, this is Optibotomus. Thank you for tuning in. I'll talk to you later.